morning, holy brothers and sisters!
It is the 18th of Sivan, and in the Kitzur Lekutei Maharan, today's lesson will be called Prophetic Pronunciations, teaching number 186. Through the faith that a person has in the words of the Tzaddik, the Righteous One, he thereby sees great wonders from him at all times. For the Tzaddik is undoubtedly full of wonders, and when a person believes in the true Tzaddik, he understands the word of the Tzaddik in retrospect. In other words, he sees in everything that happens to him, subsequent to his speaking with the Tzaddik, that this is what the Tzaddik meant by his words, for the words that the Tzaddik spoke to him were hinted to him, and that it would be exactly so. He sees that everything that happened to him afterwards was actually hinted at in the Tzaddik's words. Not only is this an aspect of prophecy in that his words come true, but we should understand on a deeper level that because the Tzaddik says these words, they thereby become the reality. Teaching number 187. It is one of God's greatest kindnesses that he punishes a person measure for measure. In this way, the person understands with what sin he blemished and he repents for it. More than anywhere else, God repays a person measure for measure in the land of Israel, since there they are exacting to repay a man in accordance with his deeds. Psalms 62:13. This is hinted at in the verse where the land of Israel is referred to as a land that eats ocheles, its inhabitants, from Numbers 13:32. The word ocheles is an acrostic for ata seshalem le'ish kima'asehu. You repay a man in accordance with his deeds. We should know that it is absolutely amazing that we can analyze what is happening to us to allow us to recognize how and what we need to do to become better. Teaching number 188. Before a person is born, they teach and show him everything that he needs to labor at and achieve in this world. But as soon as he's born, he immediately forgets everything and it is all lost. This is the reason why he must travel to the Tzaddik, namely to search for what he has lost. For everything that everyone in the world has lost is all to be found within the Tzaddik. So you and I might ask, why should we learn everything if we're going to forget it anyway? This is so that when we learn it, it will all make sense to us because we once knew it before and we have some familiarity with it and it won't be so hard that second time around. Teaching number 189. The essence of the bite of the snake is sadness and sluggishness. Therefore, a person must be extremely careful to avoid these qualities. We know that any sense of sadness or depression or frustration is only the yetzer hara, the evil inclination that is making us doubt ourselves and Hashem. We have to constantly stay connected and always be full of simcha and joy. As always, thank you so much for learning together. If you enjoyed this lesson, please remember to like, comment, share, and borrow. And please, God, we'll learn again tomorrow.